My name is Eric Plovino. I'm a senior consulting engineer at Cumulus Networks, and today we're going to talk about how to configure trunks and access ports in Cumulus Linux. For the purposes of our conversation, this is going to be our test topology. We have two leaps, LIFO1 and LIFO2, at the top of the topology. There's a single link that connects them, switch port 49 on both sides. That's going to be a trunk. And we also have two servers in our topology as well at the bottom, hanging off of LIFO1 and LIFO2. Those are both going to be configured as access ports facing those hosts, and they're going to access VLAN 10. So let's talk about how we actually configure that trunk in between LIFO1 and LIFO2. It's pretty easy in Cumulus Linux. We're going to use the NCLU, or the Network Command Line Utility. We're basically going to have two commands here that we issue. We're going to create VLAN 10, and then we are going to add switch port 49 to the bridge. So let's take a look at our demo environment and get started. We'll start on LIFO1. Let's take a look at the interfaces before we're getting started. We'll run the net show interface command. You can see it's pretty simple. We don't really have anything that interesting going on here. We have an ETH0 interface, which is connected to our management environment, and that's how we're logged into the device right now. Nothing else is really up and interesting aside from the loopback. So we're going to create that VLAN 10. I'm using tab complete here to finish out some of my commands. And then I'm going to commit those changes. And it'll tell us exactly what has been added to the Linux configuration. And that's what we're looking at here. Here we've created switch port 49. We have added switch port 49 to our bridge. And we've added VLAN 10 as one of the VLANs on that bridge. So if I look again at NetShow interfaces, you can see now switch port 49 is a member of the bridge. And it is in a trunk mode at this moment. It has two VLANs on it, our native VLAN or our untagged VLAN 1, as well as VLAN 10, which is the VLAN we defined. So it's pretty simple. We're going to do the exact same thing on LIFO 2. All right, now that's complete. We're going to look at the other side as well, net show interface. You can see again, switch port 49 is a member of the bridge. It's in trunk mode, and again, two VLANs on it. VLAN 1 is the native, and VLAN 10, which is actually tagged. So the next piece that we're going to take a look at is creating an access port. So again, this is pretty simple in Cumulus Linux using the network command line utility. We basically just add switch port 1 to the bridge and call it an access port, accessing VLAN 10. And we're going to do a very similar command on LIFO1 and LIFO2. So let's get started here. And we'll apply the configuration first to LIFO1. We're going to commit the change. All right, you can see we've defined a new interface in our Linux configuration, our etc network interfaces file. We've made that configuration, that port, a bridge access port at VLAN 10. And you can see we've also added switch port 1 to our bridge ports on the bridge. So all of that has been applied for us thanks to NCLU. We're going to do the same exact thing on the other side. And you can see here we have our new switch port 2 interface that's been defined. It is an access point in VLAN 10. The bridge port 2 has been added. We'll look at the NetShow interfaces as well. Again, we have the switch port 2 that's been added. It's an access port, and it's accessing the untagged VLAN of 10. So I also have my servers configured in this environment with a pretty simple configuration. If I take a peek here, you can see I've set the interfaces ETH1 up on server 01. I've added an IP address 10.1 onto ETH1, and I'm just confirming via the IP adder show command that IP address is applied. Sure enough, it is. I've done something very similar on the other side on server 02, except I've given it 10.2. So if everything's done correctly here, we should be able to ping from server 01 to server 02. And sure enough, it's good to go. So if you have any further questions about how to modify access ports or trunk ports or anything else of that nature, feel free to visit our public Slack room, slack.cumulusnetworks.com. Have a good day and a better tomorrow.